strengthened, and I'm optimistic.
Following the guarantees made by U.S. President Joe Biden on Washington's commitment to its alliance to the Philippines, another U.S. official assures Manila Washington will continue to work with the Philippines to address increasing challenges in the West Philippine Sea.
As well as issues that, like,
that statement coming from the second highest American government official, Vice President Kamala Harris, who met with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. at her official residence in Washington, D.C. on Tuesday. During their meeting, both leaders reaffirmed the strength of the partnership between the Philippines and the United States, which they say has grown stronger than ever under their current administrations.
I know the President and you had a very meaningful and good meeting yesterday, and I'm looking forward to our time together this morning. But I want to thank you because the strength of the alliance between the United States and the Philippines is probably stronger than ever. Under your leadership, we have been able to continue to do the work that we have that is a priority around our mutual prosperity and security.
The President says he is concerned by Beijing's continued provocation in the South China Sea and considers this a major issue for his administration.
How concerned are you with the continued provocation from China, regardless?
As concerned as you could possibly be. It is one of the major issues that we have to face back home.
And do you believe cooperation with the Vice President and President Biden will get you closer to protecting the region?
Well, cooperation with the United States certainly is just something that we are building upon that has been going on for many, many, many decades. And we just keep going.
Prior to his meeting with Harris, Marcos Jr. also met with the country's top security and defense officials, Secretary of State Antony Blinken, Secretary of Defense Lloyd Austin, and National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan at a dinner hosted by the Philippine Embassy Monday night.
Marcos
Jr. on Tuesday held a series of meetings, including one with the biggest American employers of Filipino workers in the United States.
You do not represent 200,000. You do not 200,000 employees. You represent 200,000 families, and you represent 200,000 communities in the Philippines.
We can only thank you all for what you recognize. What we always knew was the intrinsic value of the Filipino worker. We are an active member of the global economy, and we are participating and contributing to the global economy, as many other countries do. And that is the way of the world. And you know, the part that the employers displayed cannot be underestimated.
During the meeting, some companies revealed plans to employ thousands of Filipino workers in the next few years.
It was great, we're very excited to be invited to this event, especially at this high level of attention. Our employee, we have 30,000 employees from the Philippines at the moment, and we are looking to hire another 15,000 in the next 5 years. So this partnership is very important for us.
The President also met with a number of American businesses on Tuesday, which include vaccine manufacturer Moderna, which plans to build its facility in the Philippines. Marcos Jr. also discussed with officials of UltraSafe Nuclear Corporation its interest to build its first nuclear energy facility in the Philippines. The President, meanwhile, expressed openness to study the use of the firm's cutting-edge micronuclear fuel technology to address recent power outages in the Philippines. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.